Hey everybody, today I'm going to show you how to use the switch case in Dart, and I apologize for the example I'm going to show you because it's pretty pointless to use the switch case in this example, which is pretty much you just tap this and according to your tap then the text here will change. But it's not about the example, I just want you to understand how it works and how to use it. That's about it. So just stick around if you want to learn how to use the switch case. Let me just start by explaining what the hell is going on around here. So basically we have this variable right here, which is what is being displayed over here. Then we have these static const strings. And as you can see, you know, A is this one, B, C, and D, pretty obvious here. And the reason they're static consts is because for the switch case, you need to use constants, okay? That's the reason. And what is going on down here is essentially just, you know, a container to give the list tile a color. Then you have the text and obviously the variable answer A, B, C, D, etc. And when we tap the final result, which I remind you is this string that is being displayed right here, is going to become the same as this string. So if I tap on I feel amazing, not right now because it doesn't work, but once it works, if I tap on list tile A that says I feel amazing, then final results will become the string I feel amazing. And also, answer tapped becomes true, which is this bool right here that starts out as false. And this might be a little bit confusing, but that's because this isn't the best example for a switch case. But basically, this is false, right? And over here, which is this container right here, under the text widget, the final result is being shown only while the answer tapped is false. So once that becomes true, the result of this method right here is actually what is going to be displayed. So just to sum it up, answer tap begins as false and final result begins as this string right here, and it's being used to display this right here. This is how it starts. However, once you tap any of the list tiles, final result becomes the same as the string of the list tile. But because answer tapped becomes true, then final result is no longer being used as the string on this container right here. Instead, what will be displayed will be the result of this method right here, which is exactly where we're going to put in our switch case, which is why I so aptly called the method switch case. This is a little bit too convoluted, but I just wanted to make this video as short as possible, and I just wanted to focus on showing you how to use the switch case. So I didn't want to waste your time by watching me type code for other stuff. And speaking of wasting your time, let's just go straight into it. So the first thing I want you to understand about the switch case is that it's kind of like a method on itself, because this is the empty version of a switch case. And all you need to know is that over here, you need to put in the variable that you're going to check for. Basically, you're going to check for this, and then according to this, you will define how the switch case behaves. But that probably is confusing you, so let me just show you. In this case, we're working with a string, so basically, we're going to check what the string contains, and then if it matches the same as the case that we put in, then we return something different. Remember that this is a method, and the goal is to return a string in the end. So we're going to do case, and then I'm just going to do answer A. Then I'm going to use these little two dots, and after this, I return whatever string I want. In this case, I'm going to return you're golden because, you know, they're saying I feel amazing. And by the way, I'm saying answer A, but this could literally be just I feel amazing, you know. But since the variable is already there, let's just go ahead and use it. Now, something very important, after you define what happens if this is the case that matches the switch case, then you need to put in break, because otherwise the switch case will not stop and it will keep going through each case until the very last one. And if you have a long switch case, obviously that's not good. And by the way, if you're thinking, when should I use switch case versus if statements? In my opinion, 4 should be the limit for if statements, otherwise it just gets messy, while switch cases can be pretty long and it's not as confusing. But basically, this is case number 1, and then I can just copy this and paste it. I'm going to do this 4 times because we already know there's 4 different answers. I'm going to change this and this, and now all I gotta do is change the strings. For answer B, I'm just gonna go ahead and say, go do something you enjoy. Answer C, which is I feel okay, I'm gonna say, keep your chin up. And if the person feels bad, tomorrow will be a better day. This is not very relevant. And right now there's an error saying this doesn't return a string, but this is just a bug. This will work, don't worry about it. In fact, if I come over here I do void, then it doesn't work. And then if I switch it back to string, then it doesn't work either. So let's just go ahead and ignore it. So once again, let me just show you what happens. As you can see, the bool is on set state because we want this right here to update once we tap. And as you can see, the argument we're sending over is final results. So essentially what will be here is the final result. And remember, when we tap A, the final result equals this string right here. So essentially what we're doing is, once I tap, for example, A, then final result becomes answer A. And you're checking final results to see which one of these matches. And in this case, answer A would match, and our switch case would return your golden. So instead of just talking about it, I'm just gonna go ahead and show you. When I tap A, and as you can see, it becomes your golden. I feel okay, keep your chin up. Tomorrow will be a better day. And of course, we're always printing over here on the on tap, but that's not important. As you can see, all the cases work just fine. And that's because we're literally using the switch case right here. So I hope you understood this. Once again, we're returning the final result into the tapped answer, as in I'm going to tap. Oh, I just realized this one actually has a typo, but I think you got it still, it's okay. But essentially when I tap D, final result becomes I feel bad. And then you're checking this right here, which is essentially like it says final result, okay? And because you tap D, the case that will be true is this one right here. And so this becomes tomorrow will be a better day. And if this was not here and you tapped A, it would still work. But then the switch case would also check for answer B. As a programmer, you gotta optimize your resources. So anyway, once again, I apologize for the lack of creativity on this example, but I do hope that you were able to understand how the switch case works. And if you're having any doubts, just go ahead and try it for yourself and figure out what works and doesn't. If you did learn something, please hit that like button. And of course, if you're a beginner, go ahead and subscribe to keep on learning Flutter. Thank you so much for watching. This is Flutter Mentor, and out.